Welcome. This practice is about our immune system again. There's four lines of defence that we're going to focus on. From the skin barrier all over the body, to the mucus lining in the nostrils, so some lovely deep breaths, to thinking about the heart pump, pumping everything around the body, particularly the white blood cells that are looking for the foreign invaders, to the lymphatic system, or the lymph nodes in the groin, trunk, armpits and neck. So this will feature movement, attention to areas. So wherever your attention goes, you produce energy. So that's what we're going to focus on to start with. And it's the breath we're starting with. We're going to put those hands on this heart and try and breathe in deeply. I'm going to bring the arms up so it feels like spaciousness. We're going to make sure we pause before we exhale. And then bring everything back to our heart center. So just by feeling that in-breath widening, deepening, slowing it down, you're bringing attention to your breath pattern, saying, here I am, I'm ready for a little bit of practice for myself. Feel spacious inside, get the rib cage expanding so that the diaphragm is worked properly. And having time to breathe, really important, notice your breath. Just do a couple more. I'm going to do six ways to do the chair pose, which is a really great one for building the circulation up in the lower body, particularly using the calf muscles, the big muscle groups, and just see how many you can manage to do comfortably, no pain ever while you're doing the chair poses. So the first one we're going to do is a normal breath in. And I want you to think about expansion. I want you to think about that lovely deep breath in and that little pause before we exhale. And just bring your sort of hands down to the side of your knees. Make sure your hips go back so you're in this chair pose. And as you breathe in, we're back to the beginning again. We might even lift the toes as we stretch up. Don't forget the pause. And then find yourself in this chair. Now see if you can just take your hands just that little bit lower next time. Getting a little bit of pressure in your hands against the outside of your legs to keep that alignment. And then the last one, maybe all the way to the floor. So we've got a lovely combination of all them three depths. And then I might just find myself in a little bit of a chair just for a moment, see how it feels. Take that breath in and then back out again as I take the arms down. So one done. Now this time I'm going to reach up with one side of the body and see what it feels like as I open the side of the body here, and then just put the hands back on the thighs and get to that lovely low squat. Now this is again where you can focus your attention on the arm, so where your attention goes, you'll provide the energy all the way up with the neck and the armpits, getting that lovely stretch. And you're going to start to deepen the breath. You do as many of these as you can. Remember your quality of the movement is good, your hips are always going back, no knee pain. You've got that lovely pause before you go back into your out breath. I'm going to do one more on each side. And already you're starting to feel like there's motion in the upper body now, a little bit more warmth, obviously in the lower body. Okay, and then just bring your hands back to the starting point. Now I want to bring myself up a little bit this time. It's a bit like you're sort of saying, I'm celebrating the heart centre, the energy coming from that heart centre all the way up. Now the difference is that we're going to try and use our legs as well. So we've got squat here. We take one leg, front, side, back, and then we're back to our lovely prayers. And you can really feel that in-breath taking hold now, can't you? And the balance, testing the balance. Join that circle around you, try and get to the back of the body. So each time you do this, you just find a little bit more in your body, a bit more space somewhere. And you feel that the core muscles have to work hard. The balance has changed a little bit here. Breathe in deeply. And last time each side. So this is number three. Not that we're counting. And going into the next one. So I'm just going to try and see if I can go from my nice sort of prayer position up onto the balls of the feet and see how the balance feels at this top. And I can maybe put the heels back down, sit back in that squat, so maybe put the hands on the thighs. And then when you're ready, come back up onto the calves. So you're pumping the calf muscle here. And that's that circulation pump for the rest of the body. So if you get the ankles working, the calf muscles, it'll provide that energy up the body to the heart. And the heart comes back down again. The circulation process takes about a minute to get this full circle. Yeah, so I'm going to do one more. And I'm going to see if I can balance at the very top, if only for a moment. So test your balance. Try not to let your feet roll out. Keep that lovely core tight. Concentrate on something that's not moving. It does help. Couple of breaths in, couple of breaths out. And then you can load your heels back down again. Maybe take your feet just that little bit wider. Now this time we expand and we just think about that rib cage, that big deep breath here. And making it very full here. So this is when I'm breathing in and this is when I'm exhaling. Now just to add a little bit of the chair to it, because that is what we're doing here. You sit back in your hips here. And then you can really feel how that ribcage area expands on the in-breath with your arms up. And then it's a little bit of a deflation and a letting go feeling as you exhale. Keep looking at the floor. See if you can try and delay that breath a little bit on the in-breath here. So in-breath here, and I'm just holding it for a moment before I exhale. How's that feel? One more time down. And finally up, and then just come out of that feeling. We've got one more to do, and then we're targeting this time the area around the groin with a nice crescent moon. Now some of us will not be able to get back on our toes, so if I just show you what I'm doing, I'll start off in my almost chair and I'm going to try and take one leg back and see if I can get myself into this crescent moon. So from the side, I'm going to try and take one leg to the back and see if I can load that position. So remember, the pelvis is in neutral, hip bones, pubic bone in a nice vertical alignment, and just bring your arms over your head. And then you go back into that little squat and then you take the leg on the opposite side back. And if that you're struggling with your knees or the toes, just watch me, yeah? Enjoy yourself, just watching me. Just take your arms up and down. Don't bother with the deep squats. How does that feel? Just keep that one going in your own rhythm. And keep squatting. Seeing if you can take the legs back. Raise your arms. You can feel that you're targeting that little bit, the crease between your thigh. Whoops, and your pelvis. And definitely my balance. I like to fall over on cue. Remember that in-breath here. And one more. Now I want you to finish, if you can, with your right leg in front. We can do it together. Yeah, and we hold it for a moment. So we try and grow a little bit here. On the in-breath we grow. On the out-breath we sink. So reach up and then sink down again. So you're balancing on the ball of your foot if you're still with me. And you're feeling like everything's shifted up. You lengthen your spine on the in-breath. You start feeling them big muscle groups, that quad at the front, really working hard to maintain this. Keep that back leg really stable. So it's about four breaths here. And then just take your arms down, straighten your front knee, and see if you can put your back heel down onto the floor. So we've got both legs straight. How does the calf feel? Are we still smiling? Try and keep your hips square. Now see if you can go back up into that lovely crescent moon. Lift your heel off, bend your front knee, in breath. As you load that heel to the floor, straighten the knee. Breathing in, reaching up. Breathing out, lowering it down. We'll do one more of these and you're finishing. Remember, you've got that right leg in front. Just going to hold it one more time. Breathe deeply. And put that heel down. just end this section thinking about, it's almost like a pyramid pose. So the back leg is straight, so you're going to pull the crown of the head away from the hips. Just for a moment, just put a little bit of pressure in that back line, yeah, the back calf. And then you get to a point where you've had enough, you soften your knee and you take your fingers to the floor. And that's where you're nourishing your belly to your thighs. Important part now, your head. Yes and no, nod the head. Let it go from side to side, you know, so make sure you don't make yourself too dizzy, but really relax your neck. If you're able to straighten your knee, wait for your out breath and just straighten your knee a little bit at the front. And then on your in breath, just soften your knee and relax. As you exhale, straighten your knee. And then when you've had enough, I've got my hands on the floor. I'm going to follow my back leg to my front leg. And then I'm going to come up, breathing in. Feel that comfortable end there for a moment. Okay, so if your dog doesn't annoy you, it's not my dog by the way, we're going to try stepping back again. So remember, we started in a sort of a squat. Take a leg back, doesn't matter which one, because we're going to end up with that left leg in front, I hope. And then take it back down. So on the in-breath, rise. And on the out-breath, come back into this low-ish chair. See if you can get that rhythm of the breath again, the in-breath and that lovely, I'm almost a pause in it at the end, and retaining the breath. Lovely. So we feel a little bit more vibrant now. So I'm going to do one more, and then hopefully I've got my left leg in front. So wait until you've got your left leg and stay there. So I'll wait for everyone to catch up. So you may want to bend your knee a little bit more at the front. Imagine when you breathe in, you're attached to the ceiling, you reach up towards it, and as you exhale, you sort of soften down a bit and you might even go lower. So we did about 30 seconds of this, yeah. About 4 deep breaths in, and a lovely out one as well. Don't forget the out. Can you feel how the thigh at the front's working hard, the leg at the back? Hold it there, I'm doing one more. Breathing in. And exhale. So didn't it feel good when you take your arms down? Now straighten your front knee, straighten your back knee. Yeah, see if you can find that tension in the calf. How different is that leg, yeah? So only when you're ready, you're gonna go back to that lovely crescent moon. So you bend your front knee, you lift your back heel off and you reach. And as you come back down, calf goes back into stretch. Reaching up the front line, bending that knee, try not to grip your toes too much. Are we finding ourselves stretching ourselves a little bit, feeling that skin, getting that breath going, getting the circulation going, moving things around the body, which is what we're after. Yeah, flow. Okay, 4, 3, 2. Wonderful. Straighten the legs, hands maybe on your hips, because you're going to pull the crown of the head away from your hips, what you're holding. You go over slowly. And you know when you can't stand it anymore, you bend your knee and you fold your belly onto your thighs and you go to the floor. And that's where you hang around for a few moments. Don't forget the yes and the no of the head. Don't want to be on red alert. Keep it relaxed, chin to chest. If you're breathing and stretching, go for it. Straighten the knee, exhale. Relax on the in-breath, if that's possible. And if not, just dangle more, relax more. Then a step forward and come up, breathing in. Doing well. Hopefully I feel better for that. So I'm just going to widen the legs just to take it into another pose. Yeah. So to start with, just notice how the hips feel in this position. Remember the hands on the front of the pelvis here. Make sure you've not got the tailbone tucked under or over too much. It's a very sort of neutral pelvis. You can maybe start with some movement in the rib cage a little bit from side to side. So it's a little bit like a gliding action on the ribs. Pain free, or don't do it. Yeah, either way, just to get movement in that area. And then I'm going to pick the energy energy, so that feels okay. I'm going to pick the energy up, put it back down again. Pick the energy up, put it back down again. Yeah, it'll all make sense shortly this, yeah. I'm going to bring it to the bottom, to the top. Yeah, just see if you can feel that energy. We'll progress with that in a moment, yeah. So right 90, left 15. External, internal rotation. See if you can point your hip bones back to the front. And we prepare a little triangle again. So that gliding action, really useful for anyone who's a little bit stiff in the side of the body. Just find that a little bit less painful. And then you can maybe load the triangle, you know, go to whatever's comfortable. And a little go expansion. Yes, it's like, look at the space I have now got in the body to flow everything through. We don't want, you know, any kinks in the body. We want to make sure whatever feels good on the outside will feel brilliant on the inside. Yeah, so the triangle, reaching upwards. You could take the arm down if that feels really, you know, uncomfortable, and concentrate on the neck here. Concentrate on the neck by moving the arm, by the way. And then reverse it, bend your knees. This is a sort of sun warrior style with the other arm going up. You can feel how things move around on this side as well. So you've got breath in, pause, exhale. I'm going to go back into my triangle one more time. So we go straight arms, glide for a few moments. Hold it, breathe. Any different the second time? Always is, isn't there? And then back into the sun, which by the way is out today. There is sunshine out today. Okay, so we did a little bit of a turn, but this time get your feet rotated outwards. So I've got this semicircle, and now I can just give it a little bit more emphasis on the side down up feeling. And I'm moving that energy, focus on your hands. So when you bring the attention to your hands, feel that furthest point away. Yeah, you might go all the way around, just play with it. You might just sway. Okay, you might do this lovely heart mudra. Open the heart, here I am, breathing in, breathing out. And meanwhile, back in the leg department, you're getting some lovely deep squats there. Well, concentrate on the breath. Expand, yeah. Getting warm as well. One more time. In and out. Okay, so we do the other side just to see how that feels. So we've got the left and we've got these hips pointing back to the front of the room. Think of where your mat is. Yeah, I can do a little bit of a side bend or a preparation. If that feels good. Prepare yourself. Yeah, so once I've prepared, I can do side bends here, pain free, reaching up. I might decide, you know, not to stay in it. I might just keep going into the side bend preparation. I'm not there with you, so please do not overdo anything. Head to the floor. Arm might be the lead for the neck area. We're talking about the lymphatic system in the neck, remember? And reaching up over the head, feel the armpit here as well. Nice stretching skin. Couple of breaths in, couple of breaths out, then try the triangle combo again, side bend. Reaching up, extending. And then our lovely sunshine, nearly there. Should be warm now. Okay. I'm just going to take myself into a nice forward bend, put the hips back, tuck the chin. I might go over and stay here. I might come back again, utilise my back line a bit more. Use some core muscles on the way down, all the trunk there, working hard. Hands may find themselves on the floor eventually. So I'm trying not to look at the camera and hurt my neck. So keep looking down, relax your jaw. And you're going to bend one knee, so you target the groin. Bend the other, just keep walking from side to side. Use your out breath to really hold that movement. In breath, out breath. Just a couple of nice movement patterns there. You could straighten and bend the knees. Maybe finish with your hands, walk them out a bit, put your hands on the floor, like walking a plank basically. You've got your four points here. Walk on the spot with your heels up and down. So if you've done the down dog before, you've got this action of pumping the calf muscles, which is a lymphatic pump around the body. You might have a little wiggle with the bum, yeah? Drop it down for a second, load your knees. See how it feels to do the other area, so you're extended. So I'll just show you from the side here. And then you roll your toes under and try and go back up into the down facing dog. Just keep that flow going. You should feel quite refreshed after all that standing work. So get the pelvis tilted, your arms strong. Try and work the calf muscles. Feel the trunk working, feel the neck, feel the armpits. All the things that we're trying to work, and if not, work on the calf muscles, pump them a little bit, you know, just try and get yourself onto either position, yeah? You could load yourself back a bit more if you don't like the stretch going on there. That could be a nice position. Stay there for a few seconds, let yourself breathe. I'm going to finish it off with this lovely pose that can affect people's knees, so just work on whatever you can manage here as you breathe in. You're reaching up, so it's a bit like the full complete breath again. And as you turn your body, your chest, your head, your hands, your attention goes to the back of the room or towards that hand, and then reverse. And feel that you're getting that spaciousness in your body as well. Now this is a bit like a chair. As you go back, your hips go back, and you get to that point where you're really analysing the balance in the body as well. Forehead might go down as I breathe in. I lead with the heart, I come up, I breathe in. Guess what, go the other way. And in, and out. Lovely, and then just get yourself back in the child pose, the hands behind for a moment, check you've got no knee issues here, forehead to the floor. Couple of breaths in through your nose, out through your nose. Feel that belly expand on the in-breath. Feel yourself almost deflate as you exhale. So fill yourself up and then let yourself release. Yeah, just that for a few moments. And then I just want to finish in the bridge and make it a nice sort of compliment. So you've stood up, we've done it in 4 points and we just finish on the back today. So get yourself comfortable on your back. You may prefer to stay, you know, in the child pose. I'm just going to move so that you can see me on the floor. Okay. And I'm showing how to do the bridge. But just in case you've forgotten, it's about lifting the hips into the air. So if you can imagine I'm doing James Bond here. Yeah? The arms just are going to go out and they're going to come back again. So I want to time my openness, the hips coming up on the in-breath. And as I go down, together. So just finishing off with this lovely tuck of the chin, lifting of the hips. And it's another strong one for the big muscle groups. The bridge is a really great one for the back of the body here, especially if you sit a lot. So we're trying to take the kinks out around the groin area, around the hips. Trying to get the power in the core working here. We're trying to get the shoulders relaxed, the arms aware, the armpits working. So just a couple more of these. Remember how we started, we focused on the skin. So we've got some really lovely awareness of how the body's moving. We've done the breath patterns to work the mucus lining in the nostrils. So a lovely breath through the nose. We thought about the circulation, the white blood cells through the body, catching all our invaders as we do some lovely deep breathing and move the body well. And then finally targeting them little areas that the lymphatic system gets rid of the invaders, armpits, neck, trunk and the groin. So a few of those, I'm going to bring myself to the side. The dogs are barking, the neighbours are knocking. I think it's time to stop. So just get back into a cross-legged position for a moment. Finish off with this lovely hand pattern here. So I've got the left hand near the body and the right hand on top. The thumbs touching, it's a little bit like the swallow position here, yeah, this lovely Garuda Mudra here. Nice expansive one to finish, yeah. So while you're sat relaxing, focus on that imaginary journey of the pumping of the blood through the entire body. That lovely deep breath in through the nose, out through the nose. And maybe finish trying to lengthen the out breath as you finish your little practice today. So you've had a nice combination of breath patterns there, from the deepening of the in to the lengthening of the out. And be amazed at how wonderful that body is, inside and out. All the things it does for you on a daily, minute by minute basis. Lift that heart center, expand on your in-breath. Let go of what you don't need as you exhale. Keep that energy flowing for the rest of the day. So wherever your attention goes, energy follows. So let's keep that energy on the height today. Really important. So thank you for joining me. I'm going to wish everybody a big namaste. And keep safe. Look after your bodies. And I'll see you soon. Thank you.